please, please, please do not for one second imagine that it's your job to become the scaffolding for those who are falling. You can interpret this in whatever way you feel like. But you question whether or not it is your job to be reinforcing, propping up, assisting, helping, caring for, or whatever term you want to use, those people who are, let's say, are not going to continue. And who you know, it's okay that they're not going to continue. You ask yourself that question because you're going to need to know the answer, because it's going to happen. This is a drama in which the protagonist and antagonist, there's a relationship. So the individual is going to have to look into this whole question of dependency. Who are you dependent on? Who are you making dependent on you? Who's asking you to become dependent on them? Who lacks the independence? And what happens if you pull away your energy from those people? You know, if they fall, can you let them fall? Or are you going to spend your life, you see, you know, propping up other people who haven't not got their own stability? You know, is that divinely correct to do that? Is it really in the intention of the true spirit to do that? Maybe it's more spiritual to let people like that fall, because at least it's a natural thing. Out of that fall, they may grow. They may end up, you know, really passing the tests. Whereas if you're constantly propping them up, you may be violating fate. You may be going against the natural flow of things. But I really encourage people also to not be too speculative about, you know, oh yeah, what's going to happen in the age of Aquarius, you know? Well, whatever's going to happen is going to happen. You're not going to be around anyway to work it out. So worry about right now the world and the life that you're in, and avoid all these other escapes of what might be tomorrow, and exactly what the, you know, clothes they'll be wearing in the Aquarian age, and what the hairstyles will be like, and, you know, will God really come down to earth in a big chariot, and all of this stuff that preoccupies so many people, you know? That's all pipe dreaming. Anything could happen, you know? Let your imagination roam free, but really bend your practical interests in what is happening now. You're living in an age in which you're meant to be an observer of it. You're meant to be like a sort of a super journalist. It's like that movie, you know, The Day the Earth Stood Still, where the guy comes down, you know. Each individual living today can adopt that kind of understanding. You're here witnessing something incredible. And you should laugh, and you should cry, and you should weep, and you should mourn, and you should be exalted. You should see all of it. But also keep a certain healthy sense of, you know, detachment from it all. Never forgetting that, you know, you have your particular priority and your sovereignty. And then there's the actions of other people in the world. They're two separate things. Because too many people, I think, who want to end government control, set up another kind of control of their own. This is another, you know, problem that has so beset previous reformers, in which everyone thinks, you know, some person thinks they got all the answer, so they take down one tyrant only to become the next one. And that's why I'm so skeptical and really don't pay a slightest interest to what politics is doing, you know, in the political milieu. Because, yeah, you can throw around a lot of brilliant ideas stolen from other philosophers and psychologists and great men, but when you actually try to apply it politically, what you not often get is another form of tyranny. I mean, if you wrote down on a piece of paper all the pros of the democratic system, it would look wonderful. You know, if you wrote them down, it would just seem, oh, we have to have this. Yeah, well, we do have it, and it's not that great. So there's a difference between the ideology or the philosophy of a particular system and the actual practicality of it. You know, socialism promised so much to foreign immigrants, you know, did it really work? Are those immigrants really assisted? Is any of the people involved in all of that assisted? No. The World Bank promises to take your debt and just help you have a wonderful, thriving civilization in the nation. Has that happened? No. They can't even take care of the Western civilization. It's crumbling at the seams. They can't even fix that. Because then consciousness has been left at the door, and the fundamentals of man being introduced to what he is and turned into his inner republic have been completely forgotten. Man is a genius of an architect when it comes to the outer world. He's created incredible things. Computers, you know, jet planes, and all sorts of marvelous stuff. But the sad thing about it is, and I believe it's also due to manipulation, age-old manipulation, is that he has sort of overlooked and escaped from and denied his inner temple. And so this is where the danger arises, where it becomes inevitable that at some point in life you will have occult knowledge, sacred knowledge, precious knowledge falling into the hands of wrong people. When you look at any advertisement, when you look at any graphic, you're seeing art that is brilliant, brilliant, brilliant art from people of, you know, the level of Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo. Very, very skilled artists. But what are they doing? They're selling you some toothpaste or some stupid car. Think of what, you know, and Peter Jackson has proved that, as many others have. What would happen if those people had turned their talents to the uplift of mankind and to the education of mankind? And incredible stuff. Instead of everyone buying the same ugly looking car, what would it be if you had companies that said, hey, come and design your own? We're a company that builds cars, but we build them in any design you feel like. So you send a, you come in, you learn about it, and you submit your designs, and we will build your car. You pay for it just like you pay for a regular, but it's your car. You can even have your name on it. No more personalized number plates. You can have a personalized car. How about that? Do you know how that would turn people on? You know how kids would just love that? You know, so for every little thing we have in our world, there's an alternative way of doing it. There's an alternative setup. And you see this now a little bit with the MySpace, YouTube, Google generation. You see that innovation cropping up a little bit, you know, with people doing different things musically and different things in video. And that's really healthy to see that. Because Aquarius, the Aquarian energy, the age of Aquarius, the scorpionic rebellious energy, does operate that way. It operates on a grassroots level. The solutions will be of a grassroots nature. Corporate America just doesn't have it, you know. This is not stuff that's going to come down from the penthouse at all. It's not going to be something that's organized. But people need to really focus on the fact that it's a study. You're living in a time in which you should never feel emotionally down about the things that are happening. You should realize that you are part and part of a new paradigm. Because the battles of old were always fought with weapons, and that's useless. The new battles of the world need to be fought with strategy and intelligence.
One thing is sure, a great change of our psychological attitude is imminent. That is certain.
And why?
Because we need more. We need more psychology. We need more understanding of human nature, because the only real danger that exists is man himself. He is the great danger. And we are pitifully unaware of it. We know nothing of man, far too little. His psyche should be studied, because we are the origin of all coming evil.
Source of all coming evil. It's a provocative statement, all right. By the same token, though, man could also be the source of all coming good. I guess our future is what we make it. It all comes down to a matter of choice. And maybe there's nothing we can do about good and evil. Maybe they're absolutes. In the end, it all comes down to our attitudes towards these realities of good and evil, freedom and enslavement. History has shown us that even when men are forcibly chained and incarcerated, they can still be free inwardly, in their minds and in their hearts. Whatever the future brings, this is the important thing to remember.